Welcome student, my name is Raj Barge. I am co-founder director of Raj Computer Education. Now today we will be talking on the topic which is called as JavaScript, or technically sometimes it is called as JScript. So what are the topics we are going to cover today? We are going to cover basics of JavaScript. Second thing, we are going to create JavaScript development tools. What are the tools available to develop JavaScript? What is commenting here? How to write first program? What is loosely typed? JavaScript with different kind of browsers and how they are operated. Let's start. So first of all, you should know what is JavaScript. So this is the definition of JavaScript. JavaScript is a dynamic computer programming language. Basically, it is a lightweight and it is designed for web pages. Fine. It is basically commonly used for web pages. And this is executed on client side. That means when you are writing any kind of web applications, there are two sides, server side and client side. Server side, where data is being processed, and client side is your machine or your laptop where your browser opens. So that is client side. So this JavaScript work on client side. It works into your browsers. This is browser dependent language. Fine. And it allows or it helps you to create dynamic pages. First of all, when JavaScript was started, it was not called as JavaScript. It was first known as LiveScript, and it was first developed with a company called as Netscape. Then Netscape, after development of its first version, the first version of Netscape was Netscape 2.1, and it was in 1995. They renamed it to LiveScript, and then after this, when it was very famous with Netscape LiveScript, then Internet Explorer and Chrome both has taken it. Fine. And now it's available with different kind of browsers. Now why it is required, and what are the this is the standard, that is ECMA-262. This is the standard of testing your JavaScript or writing a JavaScript specification. JavaScript is very important because it is lightweight. That means the code is very small. It comes into KB. Fine. Next, it is designed to create network-centric applications. That is, it is basically written for writing web applications. Then, basically, it is integrated with Java. Barabar hai. But try to remember, JavaScript and Java, these are two different products. But only they are having name in their common. Next, it automatically integrates with HTML. And last and very important thing, it's open source and cross-platform. What is open source? We don't have to pay any kind of charges to run JavaScript. And next is cross-platform. That means it works with all the operating systems. It works with Chrome, it works with mobile, it works with laptop, it works with Windows, it works with Linux, and so on. So after that, we are starting with the second thing. What are the tools available to write JavaScript? Basically, the tools which are famous in JavaScript in olden days were, first, Microsoft FrontPage. This is the product of Microsoft which was designed for that. Instead of this, we'll be using today Visual Studio. Fine. And we'll be using very lightweight version of Visual Studio, that is Visual Studio 2010. Second, it was very properly designed with Micromedia Dreamweaver. Basically, it is just called as Dreamweaver. This is the product which again was very famous to design and websites into HTML and JavaScript. Even it also supports XML and XML. XHTML and XML both. Fine. And then there is something called as Micromedia Home Site for you. This is again and one kind of tool where we are going to write it. But as a student, we are going to just download a software which is called as Notepad++ and write a small application here. So what is my second part? My second part is to write in JavaScript. See, very important, when you write JavaScript anywhere, basically we write this kind of syntax, that is a script. We call this as a script tag. So this is the beginning of the script tag, this is the ending of the script tag. This script tag has two attributes. The first attribute is a language and second attribute is a type. By default, all the browsers are supporting with JavaScript, but VB also, this Microsoft also supports one more scripting language, that is VBScript. Now it is very much outdated. Even Microsoft prefers using JavaScript, but they don't officially announce it. because that might have some problem kind of thing. Fine. Next, there is something called as type. So when you say type, we have to specify in JavaScript we will be using text or JavaScript. So let's try to write it. So when you write in JavaScript, it is embedded into HTML. So how I write? It's very simple. I go to my Notepad++. Fine. I write code here. So what code I write? I write same code here. Then I prefer using only one type of script. So I remove this VBScript. If you don't specify language na, then also it is default. It is default same in JavaScript. So there is no need to specify, but as a syntax we are specifying it. And the type is text object this. Now inside this, if you want to print anything, we'll be saying document dot WRIT write, and we'll be saying semicolon. See, now this JavaScript, Java, C languages, or C sharp all follow similar kind of syntax. They follow same structural syntax of C. So what is that? This is an object. This is the method into this. How I know this is object? Because this object which is having method, that is property into this, and this is, I'm saying method or function because it is having round brackets. At the end, when the function is terminated, we'll be using semicolon. Now if I had to say welcome to JavaScript, so I'll be saying welcome to JScript. Fine. I save this. Now if you are saving this, mostly I save my all programs on desktop. So I go to desktop. I choose lecture and I try to save it here into Raj Computers. Okay, I'll be saving into a new folder that is called a JScript. Now I don't prefer writing this, I'll be saying lecture lecture J Java SCRIPT script. I save my first program here, and when you save this first program, I'll be saying let this be called as what? First.html. I save this program specific with the extension HTML because it has to run in browser. So now when I go to my desktop, in my lecture folder, see, I do have a script folder here. This should be open in browser. So what is the normal way? I drag and drop mostly. I open a new tag here. Fine. I choose this file and drag and drop here. Fine. So when you drag and drop, that program is open. And when that program is open, it is saying welcome to JavaScript. Barabar hai? So this JavaScript works very simply. It's work with very comfortable thing. Now suppose I am to add HTML tag. I'll be adding HTML tag in this browser. I'll be saying H1. That is heading 1. I'll be starting here. Slash H1, I'm ending here and saving it. I will be saying just refresh. See, when I say refresh, my JavaScript programs automatically refresh. And to make it center align, so I have to go here and I have to say align is equal to center. And if you want to specify, then you have to use single quote. Because inside double quotes, since these are two double quotes, inside these double quotes, we'll be using single quotes. Fine, let's check it out. Refresh. It's working fine. So this is the example of writing a JavaScript. This is the first example. Now second, we'll be going for next topic. How to write any comments here? It's a C similar language. So what we write into C, when it is double slash slash, it's a single line comment. And when it is star slash slash star, it's multi line comment. So when I go here, I click on here, if I want to write something in JavaScript, inside this I'll be saying slash slash, okay? Wish welcome message. You know what is comment? The comment is that thing which is ignored by the compiler. So when I compile this, refresh this, nothing happens. But when I right click this, I go into source page, I'll be able to see that. See, my comment is that. Fine. And my program executes. So when you right click and open JavaScript, it shows the code behind it. But when you come to this, it will not show the code, it will execute that the code. Fine? That is the most important thing you should understand. The code is not displayed, it is executed. And see, and if you make some kind of mistake, suppose example, I come here, I misspelled this W, I write this W as capital. see C JavaScript, Java, C sharp, all are sensitive languages. So when I come here, I say refresh, it should show me an error. So error is not visible to me. How I can see that? So you right click it, you go to inspect, and you have to wait for a few minutes, few seconds, and it shows C 1 year. What this one indicates? There's one error here. So when I click on this console, I'll be seeing what kind of error it is showing. It is showing this is the error message. See, when you are writing Java HTML or CSS, you don't see errors, but errors are shown into Java script because it's a scripting language. It's not formatting language, it's a scripting language. So document.write CMI W is capital, so I go back here and make this smaller W. I save this and update it again. Error is gone. Fine. So in this lecture we also added with something. What we added with? Displaying error. Display error. Fine. It displays error into what? Into inspect element, inspect console, na? Console. Fine. So this is done. Let's move to next thing. Next is, this is very important thing which I mentioned it already. JavaScript is case sensitive. So upper and lower makes difference to it. See, if you are writing any kind of JavaScript, if you are writing professional JavaScript, then this JavaScript has to be altered. See, this executed, but it is going to have some HTML format. So what is that format? It's very simple. You have to write it's doc type, na? Document. I should start with HTML first. I should start with HTML tag. So this is HTML. This is the start of the HTML. This is the end of the HTML. Now this HTML is divided into two parts. It is head and fine. And this is body. Whatever I'm going to execute, whatever I'm going to display, whatever I'm going to display, that should be part of body script. So this is the normal syntax of writing a proper example. See, it is showing no errors. The no errors, errors are not shown in console also, and displays output. Fine. After that, I want to explain this thing which is very important. See, when you are writing any kind of JavaScript, where you can write JavaScript? So you can write JavaScript in as an external file. Fine. You can write JavaScript into header section of your HTML. Third, you can write as we return into body container part. And last, we can write JavaScript into HTML tag also. Now, which is the right way to use? Mostly for testing purpose, we write this JavaScript into HTML level. But in other cases, we write into page level. But standard way of writing JavaScript files and programs is writing into external file, which is a professional way of doing it. So this is the main thing which you are going to learn. But you can write your JavaScript into these four ways. Let's check out how to write it. So if you are writing this JavaScript, let's check it out how things are being executed. I think for this writing this JavaScript as a file, we have to have an external file here. Fine. So let's start. So I'll be going with the same example. I copied this. Fine. I copied this, and I go for another file. I rename. I save this file into same folder. I'll be calling as a ex example 2.html. So it is written. Now I have to write my JavaScript into my header section. So I will just check it out how it is written. So I go into header section. Fine. Let me undo this. I go into header section first. I paste it there and I just display a message here. So when you display any kind of message, you have to say ALERT, alert. and this displays the message box. Again, it should end with semicolon. It says, I am in header. So header script is executed first. So I come here. I again open my new browser. Fine. I drag and drop that JavaScript code. This is my example. I drag and drop here. And it executes. And as soon as it executes, it shows me a message. See, normally this kind of message we see. After seeing this message, this is the code which we are writing in header. What we see in body? In body, we don't show alert here. We try to, or we can show it. See, I'm writing one here just to identify this is the first one. I'm coming into body section, I'm just saying two. Fine. And now I'm saying body. If I refresh this, I say okay, I say refresh, see it comes into header first and then it executes body part. So now I'm writing my JavaScript. I can write my JavaScript first into header or I can write into bodies. Now I have to just check it into button. So what is that? I'll be saying input tab type is equal to button. Type is equal to button. Value, that is the text which is displayed on button, is what? Click me. And on click, what it should do? On click, what it should do? Fine, it should say something to me. See, first of all, I will just refreshing this. It shows me button, second, third, and shows me button, but does nothing. So on click, what I do? I write code here. I say alert. Fine, and inside alert, it's see, I'm writing double quotes, K under single quote. Fine, we're writing here. I'll be saying this is the third point when I clicked on and this happens. Inside button, or it's better if I say on click event. I save this, I refresh it. See, the first thing I see, header, body, a button is shown. When I click on button, it shows me that message. Now, how to create external file is very important. When you create external file, we mostly create a folder here. So I go here, I create a folder in JScript. And that is, see, when I was doing this folder, when I was creating this folder for JavaScript, I first named as JavaScript. In all the industries, all the files are named, all the JavaScript programs are stored into JScript folder only. Fine. Even we can have other folders also. So what folder other we have? We have folder for CSS. We have folder for images. We have folder for what? Database. We have folder for documentation. Fine. We have folder for PHP script or ASP.NET script. Fine. And so on. We have n number of folders. But we will be focusing on this. So in this folder, we are going to create a file with extension .jsp. Fine. So that is JavaScript. Fine. So how to create it? Go into this file. Fine. Open new page and just write the function here. So how to write a function? It's very simple. You can just say, when you're writing JavaScript function, you have to say function as a keyword. Just say show hello. Fine. Say I'm using a camel style here. You know what is camel style? That means the first letter of the function will be small and all others will be capital. But that is only for functions. When it is the case of the class, then all the letters of the first, all the words, first character will be caps. So I can just say alert, and I can just say here, this is the fourth point I'm calling on. So I'll be saying welcome to JScript file, that is external file. Now how to add this external? See, this is my external file. I have to first save it. So how do I save it? I go into my folder again. This time I don't save into this. I go for a special folder, that is JScript folder, and save file here. I'll be saying this file as what? JS, or I'll be saying main.js, because this is my main script. You can have any name to this script file. So I save this. Once this is saved, we should be able to call this. So our this is our example where we can call it. So there are two steps. Fine. First, call the file. So I go into header section. Fine. And see, in this syntax we have written script source file ka path and things are over. So I'll be doing same thing again here. I'll be saying script fine. Source file. उसका path क्या है? The path is ये from current location. There is folder called as jscript and inside jscript we are having main.js ka file. It is a normal practice, all JavaScript files are having an extension that is .js. So I write it here. Now we should be able to call it. So I want to call this. So again I added a button. Fine, I'll be saying for jscript external file. And in this, on click of this event, I'll be calling that function. So how to call the function? I think the function name is show. It was show.
Hello.
Hello. Okay, fine. And semicolon. Let's check it out. We have to save this external file first. It is saved. We have to save this program, and then you are going to refresh it. So we'll be having two buttons now. See, the head is there. We come to body, second part, third part we have clicked on click me, and fourth we have to click this external file. When I click on external file, what happens? There is some problem here. So what kind of problem is that? Again we have to right click it. We can choose inspect element. It has to show some error.
We did not mention the value
source. So here we are there. Now it's showing some error. I click on this error. It is saying show hello is not defined. So I will just check it out, ki what is my function name. So I go to main third file, it's show hello. Show hello, is the spelling correct? I think the spelling is correct. Is that, is the file path correct? I think the source spelling is SRC, this is wrong. Fine, again come here, I refresh this. First, second body, third button click me, and fourth calling external file. I think it is working. Yeah, it's working. Fine, so it is executed. This is all. If you have any doubts, you can just call me on my company address. This is my company address, you can just call me. Thank you.